And welcome back to another riveting episode of Dorker Dudes. Good to be here, man. High five.
Good to be back here again on episode two of our show.
Of Dorker Dudes. I am, as always, your host, Jon Helmholtz, and...
And I am Dustin Perro.
The main host.
The main host, of course.
The producer, more or less. We have some really...
host duo.
We have some fun games that we're going to be playing today. We're going to be doing a little bit of throwback like we did last time, but we're going to be kicking off the episode with some Halo Combat Evolved, one of our favorite levels off of the first game.
Iconic as well,
and then we'll probably be talking about some gaming news, and then we're going to go a little bit of old school on some World War I Battlefield 1.
Going many years back ago in World War I. This should be exciting, Jonathan.
It'll be very exciting. So, Dustin, we have prepped up here the fourth mission of Combat Evolved. This game came out in, what was that, 2001?
Yeah, 2001, and in 2011, it celebrated its 10th anniversary, so the graphics should be a bit updated.
I hope so. So what we're looking at here is, in this part of the game, the Master Chief and some of the Marines in the game, the hero of the game, are moving on to find the plans, kind of like almost the Death Star plans of the Halo, right?
Plans slash maps, whichever you describe it as.
They're trying to figure out how are we going to destroy it. So it's kind of like a Rogue One mission of Halo.
Oh my God. But after Reach, man, spoiler alert if you haven't seen it yet.
Yeah, there's too much. So why don't we go ahead and get this started.
Here we go, ladies and gentlemen.
I remember one of my favorite parts about this level was how much it felt like the attack on Normandy in World War II. I don't know, like
yeah, except without the helicopters that have jets on them.
Right, exactly. All right, so here we are coming in. This does look pretty great. So this was such a cool idea for them to try to give a little bit of an updated look.
Good close-up.
Because if you look back at the original, it's, where are you? You're not here yet.
Oh, I will be on the beach very soon.
I'm in the other. They have no idea what they're getting themselves into.
They have no idea what they're about to experience.
All right. Look at that water. Such nice looking water.
That is some view.
All right. They're getting dropped in. All right. Let's get ready to rock and roll. Do you want to move left?
Okay. I'm on bottom. You're on top.
That's what she said.
Yep.
Let's do this.
Remember, you got your pistol too.
So yep. the overpowered pistol.
The OP pistol. Absolutely. I always want to use left trigger to aim, but I forget that's the grenade button. So I always try to. I remember when I was playing this game earlier on, I would try to, like, if I was playing as a kid, and I would lose a couple Marines, I would have to restart the level.
Yeah, I think there's an achievement for that in Master Chief.
In this one?
Yeah.
Oh, man.
If you do it on Heroic or Legendary, if you want a challenge, then you have to make sure every Marine makes it out of this storming beach.
On Legendary?
Well, you can do it on Heroic, too.
Oh, okay, I was going to say.
Yeah, I'm trying to remember the achievement.
Legendary, like the soldiers kill themselves, basically. I'm going to get a good
Not just that, they have infinite ammo.
That is true. But I mean, they're just they die so easily in this game. Oh, it's RB to reload. I keep forgetting when they keep changing all the...
Yeah, I noticed that some of the Halo games really try to change the button schemes in almost every game.
Sure.
Not sure if Halo Wars 2 comes out.
All right, so here comes Foehammer, Echo 419. Don't ask why I remember that. I read a lot
of these. Don't ask how
books.
I remember that.
That just shows how much we really love this game. Why don't we let a Marine be on the gun, because they have, like, the best aim. Right?
I agree, and I'll drive.
Alrighty, well don't... Oh, where are you going? We didn't get a... Are you... What? You're letting me drift in the ocean?
Oh, sorry, I was...
Water damage is very serious, especially in California. Get some flooding.
But luckily we got some reinforcements with nature rain.
Oh, I jumped out. I'm so sorry.
He jumped out.
No, the same kidding. Button to reload. All right, go for it.
All right.
Wait, what happened? Oh, okay, we're in the car. Okay, so we're cruising, going on a nice beach stroll, just like down in Malibu, except there's aliens, and you could die.
Yeah.
All right, I'm gonna jump
with
out.
With more than one race.
Go ahead and use
I'll distract them, you'll flank them.
Yeah, absolutely, that's a great idea. So Dustin, what do you remember about this first game that really stuck with you, especially about this level, you think?
Well, the game in general, I really discovered this game when I was at my aunt's house, and let's just say that the music really hooked me in, and then the action came in later, long story short.
Yeah.
So I've heard...
This kind of was like a pivotal point for a lot of gamers, I feel like, was people realizing you could have more of a cinematic
experience. And I think it was also on a picture of the CD for Combat Evolved.
Oh, this level, that's right. That's what I always remember. This was that level I remember when people started doing the warthog flip, where you try to pile as many grenades as you could under a warthog.
Yeah.
See how far you could get. This is the level people will do it on.
Yeah.
So you can actually there's a second warthog you can get.
Yeah, actually, I think there is an achievement where you can do the airborne achievement, where you drive a warthog, kill the second player, and then get achievement for it. But you have to be on the other side of the island in order for that to happen.
Okay, so what I also love about this first one is how the warthogs don't take any damage. Like you could, okay, that's fine.
That was an accident, something about the controls.
Team killer.
I think you may have told me.
Team killer, don't run me over. All right, here we go. Oh, dude. Okay, here we go.
Plasma pistol. That's a good one.
Yeah, that is.
Overcharge it. Take down the shield.
Where do we have to go to, man? I always forget.
Yeah, I was waiting for you to get in the car, but I accidentally killed you.
Yeah,
but
nothing. Oh, it's here. Comes again. Here comes Dustin. Okay, there you go. You don't have a clean record, do you? Ran over too many pedestrians. All right.
More Covenant than pedestrians.
I would hope so.
I try to keep it.
Where's that landing cruiser going? See, I don't have a great range of motion. I'm like wearing. That's something they never show in this game. How does this 1,200 pounds?
Oh, so slammer grenade.
Laying into these dudes. All right. So once you clear up a little bit, let's hop out and then let's get inside. This is where we encounter our first hunters on this level, I think, downstairs.
Yeah, I think
very
so too. Either
that's
in
not very
here.
Good hide and seek. All right, there we go.
Either in here or another room where they unlock the security doors.
Well, I guess we'll find out which one of us is correct.
Yeah, let's see which one of us has better knowledge of things and better teleportation too.
Oh, okay. Here we go. Yeah, that was a great grenade. Was this the one that we get
I didn't throw that.
Elite Zealot? No, that grenade was my.
Wait, I think the Elite Zealot comes in after we get the mech.
What, the gold one, yeah?
Yeah, the gold one. Though I think that one has pretty strong shields, doesn't it?
I would love to answer that for you, but I can't consider myself an expert of zealots. Of zealot elites.
Elite zealots, not real life zealots.
Well, it's funny going back and playing this one again. I'm just gonna keep saying that because I noticed so many things now going back. But now
small
I'm gonna
tidbits.
Drive. I'm gonna run you over this time.
No, I'm gonna be your passenger side, just be safe.
Were we supposed to do something down there? I don't even remember what we're supposed to do.
I think we're supposed to go on another
parkour!
Side.
Parkour!
Vehicle parkour, get it?
Master Chief Crash Derby. All right, there's some.
This is such a great point of view of the Warthog passenger seat. I love it.
I'm gonna do some fish. Oh, dude, there's a shield.
Look at that
right
plant.
There.
That's pretty cool.
What the? Are you looking up? Are you looking up at the sky?
Oh, there's an overshield.
Ah, we don't need it.
Maybe
it's
not
for
yet.
Wimps. It's for wimps, bro. All right, we're just gonna keep cruising around.
I'll take your word for it, like a
keep
pro.
Cruising around.
Or as Get Smart would say, missed by that much.
Missed it by that much. Thank God I was nervous. I was like, I can't get reprimanded again for friendly fire. Oh, here we go.
Oh, there's some help.
Do you have any
there's some stuff behind you. There's some
help
goodies.
Back here?
Yeah,
oh,
goodies.
Pick, we're going to pick the dead. Here we go.
Yeah, the men that sacrificed to win the war.
We're going
to
take their stuff. How do you, okay, that's how I turn on the flashlight. How do you turn on, how do I switch to the plasma grenades? Is it select?
I'm trying to figure that out too.
Oh, dude, I forgot you can revert to the old game.
Yeah,
look,
I was wondering
that.
What the bell was
for.
Oh,
man,
that takes us back, doesn't it?
You know what, honestly, it doesn't even look that bad. Watch out. So if you follow, if you follow the Halo lore like I do, you know these things called hunters are actually called like
Legolo.
And they are a hive mind of like gummy worms.
Yeah, orange ones specifically.
Orange,
they don't come in various
orange
colors.
Gummy worms. And
that'd be a nice insult to them, you know? You look like gummy worms. I regret nothing.
Right before they smash you into the ground.
Yeah, but after I died,
it's
I said...
It's kind of cool. They also are the same things that make up the scarabs. So the Legolo that make up the hunters also make up that.
Sweet.
Huge. Yeah, that's a little bit of a nerd fact for you. All right. Oh, there's more dudes back here, and I realize that you're not even with me anymore. So let me get you...
Oh, we'll respawn together soon.
All right. There we go. I'm gonna grab some ammo back here. Watch out for it. Here he comes.
Recharge. Boom.
How many hours do you think? I wanted to say wasted.
Actually, on Halo Waypoint, there's a service record on Halo Waypoint where they
show that. Oh, but that's with the. I'm talking about before the internet existed. You know, before Al Gore invented the internet. How do you think people
and global warming?
Yeah, before
alerts.
He invented global warming. What do you think, how many hours do you think you've put into Halo games in general?
I know how many days I put into completing the campaign. I remember that.
You've been keeping track? Aren't we supposed to go downstairs, this thing, like, right here?
Oh, it's coming up.
Oh, is it?
We just gotta be careful with the reinforcements.
Damn, reinforcements. You're pulling them off all by yourself, Rambo. Mr. Dustin Rambo.
I can use some help from the son of Rambo.
Here we come. All right.
Like the Nintendo film, Son of Rambo.
I never watched that movie.
There we go.
Oh, yeah. Heads up, heads up.
Wish I had my Magnum back. I'm more used to that than the plasma
pistol.
Well,
because you ran me over, and then I blew you up, and then we both lost our favorite weapon.
Hopefully we can still settle our differences. Well,
nope.
Like real men.
Mm-mm. Not gonna happen. All right, how do we...
But still, we're both live now.
That's true.
Mm-hmm.
It's funny, I would say, honestly, I've probably invested hundreds of hours in games, especially when you play them on Legendary. And,
yeah, even on Legendary, I remember I completed Halo Reach in like 3.5 days up until like 4 a.m. on the last level.
That's a great game. Play that one.
Yeah.
Not today, but next episode.
Next segment hopefully.
Yeah, stay tuned for that. All right. Yeah. Oh, dude, look at all these overshields.
I thought you didn't like those.
Well,
we might need them for this part.
I'll take them when I can get them. All right, we're going to probably be running into some more.
Some invisible dudes.
Some invis. All right, here, heads up. Best way to find out if there's an invisible guy is to shoot everywhere.
Huh?
I found him. See, it worked. Oh, that's, never mind. That's a hunter.
Yeah, I was about to say, hunters are invisible too.
Could you
too.
Imagine if they gave the hunters the cloaking?
I'm punching him. I'm punching him.
Is it working? is it doing anything? Ah! Try to backhand him. Try and give me a spin.
And he's just standing there. Like, there's no reason for him to just come out and fight like a man.
Fight like a man. Maybe we should just play.
Oh, wait, never mind. That's walk like a man. There you go.
All right, here we go.
Thank you.
Okay, you think we're actually gonna get one of these objectives complete?
Depending on how fast we're going, I think we might get one or
half. Do you think our rifles run on solar power or lithium batteries?
Oh yeah, the flashlight. I thought I was talking about the game itself.
If you ever run out of grenades, just throw the lithium battery at them. All right, here we go. All right, we gotta go fight this fool, right?
Yes.
Do we have to go further into the catacombs?
I think that's a different room, the one we're supposed to go back to.
What do you think's down here? Probably death. Oh, yep.
Death from above.
Or death down below.
I think this is where
him? Oh yeah, there's this dude, there's a sword. You might wanna,
Oh, I killed one.
You take one out by yourself? I'm not even in the room, man.
Let's just say I had some experience with past gameplay.
Did you get them both?
I think so.
Both?
I thought one of them had a sword.
You didn't even save anything for me, man.
Well, I was making do with what I have, so
yeah,
no excuses.
I know. You're right.
Okay. I'll let you have the last overshield.
You know what? Mine's still up from the last one, but thanks. I'll take it. All right, so now that we're done here, can we jump down?
We can slide down to be safe.
On this one, can you die from falling damage?
It depends on how high you fall. I think every game differs
No, see, there's no falling damage in this one. It's in Halo 2 when they introduced that, because watch.
Oh yeah.
And somehow these leaves are holding up my 1,200 pound body.
Strong leaves. Thank
Strong
you.
Strong leaves.
Gravity. Thank you, Halo Rings.
Now, my shield went down. So if you do fall from a certain height, it'll actually do something to you. Oh, that's you. You chased him down. Look at him run away.
What a world.
All right. Is there a vehicle around here that we can like?
Yes, there is.
There is? Can you find it?
Right here.
Oh, you got it? Man, you're on top of everything. Makes me think that you played this level earlier, and then just pretend. Oh, heads up.
One could dream.
We got a Crash Pelican right here with a bunch of stuff in it. Isn't there a rocket launcher here?
I think that comes in. Oh yeah, it's right there. I was about to say, when does that come in?
There it is. Okay, all right. Look, you ready to?
I wasn't paying attention.
What was? Is that a grenade?
That was a plasma grenade. Luckily, the Warthog's not damaged. That's good.
Well, I said the first one they were kind enough to us to not have to. Include that. All right.
How generous of Bungie. Oh, I'm back.
Here, watch. I'm gonna back over you. Beep, beep, beep.
Oh, beep. I'm in hell already. kidding.
I'm sorry.
Feel better?
I meant to do that.
I know you did, but do you feel better?
I do feel better.
Good.
I feel like, you know, eye for an eye, tit for tat.
Food for thought.
Food for thought. Penny.
As my
penny
dad would
for
say.
Your thoughts. You use the penny for your thoughts to buy the food for your thoughts.
Well, if there's leftovers, there's food for thought.
Something to consider. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. All right. Let's go where I'm pointing.
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah, right.
That way.
Right. I don't know why. So I have a problem.
And we might get more Marines.
Games. I'm getting Snapchatted. That's distracting. I can't look at my Snapchats. Oh, that's right. There's more Marines over here. Look, we did the full circle around the island. Okay. So we got the cartographer silented. We got him silenced. Better move out of the way.
Yeah, let's...
Beep, 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 get in. All right.
All right, let's go.
All right, do you know... Where do we have to go to now?
We go the first building we went to.
Oh, yeah?
Get out of the way. Yeah, get out of the way. That song.
Do I have a horn? The Ludacris song?
Yeah. I remember hearing that in the movie Hancock with Will Smith.
That's a good movie. Let's see.
Yeah,
here.
It has superhero-ness. There
is
you
this
go.
Up this way?
Up this way, yes. Hopefully we can get down there in like a minute.
Yeah, we have only a minute left.
Oh, dude. Oh, maximum carnage. Vehicle manslaughter.
I didn't mean to do that. I'm just a terrible
driver. Watch out.
He's got himself a fuel rod cannon.
Wow, isn't he
Is
he a tough...
Let's see how many of these dudes we can...
Mr. Stompy Wompers.
Oh, can we... Do you think we can run these guys over?
I hope so.
He's gonna take us
I don't remember
here.
If he's...
Wait. I have the rocket launcher. Jump out.
Okay. I'm coming out.
Boom! So we'll be right back with Dorker Dude. Stay tuned.
Stay classy, Spartans.
I love that rocket launcher.
I like it a lot.
So you have to wonder, with a name like the Death Star, it's not like very creative.
Are
like
we live?
Giant kill ball. Oh, hey, what's up? Welcome back to Dorker Dudes. We're going to be jumping right back into the Halo Fest. We decided that maybe it'd be good to jump from Halo 1 to Halo 4. So this is one of my favorite missions from the fourth one. This came out back...
Our favorite, actually, since we're both
this
here.
This was your favorite one out of four,
It's one of them.
Oh, it was pretty awesome.
We have like a big surprise in the intro. Just you wait, ladies and gentlemen.
So for this mission at this point in Halo 4, Master Chief and the rest of the UNSC fighters up there in space landed on this reclaimer planet.
This shield world, as they call it.
Shield world. And so basically the Chief is trying to go through and stop the big baddie, like always. It's always one guy.
Yeah, usually he doesn't have a bodyguard, you know, he or she, give or
take.
Well,
he does in 5, but we can't play that one together. So we'll just have to lone gun it. Okay, so let's jump right in, shall
we? We lone wolf it together.
Yes, we'll be lone wolves. We won't be so alone, though, if we're doing it together, right?
Yeah, well, we got other Spartans covering our backs.
Sure.
Instead of just Marines.
I enjoyed 4 a lot. This was back in 2012. I remember going out and buying it, and I couldn't bring myself to play it because
it was on November 6th, wasn't it?
Yes, wow, that's great memory. Me and my brother have this tradition where every time a Halo game comes out, we have to beat it together on Legendary at co-op.
And that's how pros roll, baby.
When I got this one, it wouldn't let me...
That's Captain Del Rio.
The Wi-Fi I was playing off of was a restricted NAT type, and I couldn't play online with my brother, and it broke my heart. So I had to play it alone, but I hate this guy, and I'm happy that he gets
I am with you without question.
He's just an old, he's an old salty man.
He's an old salty
but
jerk.
Look at all those bars on his shoulder.
He must have ranked up a bit for being a captain.
For being a salty captain.
Now we're part of Gypsy Company.
I thought the Spartan 4s in here weren't bad.
I'm glad they have shields now instead of just armor.
Sure.
They're part of the Spartan 4 program. Here. Hi, Dad.
It's a little quiet on the Xbox, which is fine, just so we can hear the action. So
yeah, despite this hologram.
He's telling us, don't screw up, I'll fire you, Mr. Chief, you'll get fired, I'm a mean old man.
Don't backtalk me, sir.
Do you think this is the military?
That's a gravity well. We had to take out those gravity well guns in order to get the infinity out of orbit.
A human eyeball is what it looks like.
But with eyebrows, too, if you think
eyeball
about it.
Eyeball eyebrows?
Mm-hmm.
Let's skip this part because nobody cares.
Nobody All cares right. about him anyway. I mean, what I meant to say was a captain, not you. You're an awesome dorker dude.
Thanks, buddy. I appreciate it. All right, so here we go. Something I really appreciated about Halo 4 was
the sprint.
Well, it was the fact that it has the DMR, the battle rifle.
Oh, that's an excellent combination right there, ladies and gentlemen.
How do you run in this one? LB, that's right. Oh, yeah.
I'm glad you figured
everyone
it out first.
All aboard the pain train. Look at this thing, it's huge.
Yeah, it's like, a mammoth. That's a big surprise, ladies and gentlemen. The
RV,
mammoth, behold.
Ultimate RV camper. Who's driving this thing?
Actually, it's Latsky.
Oh, that's right.
Command, I think he's either Captain Latsky, I'm trying to remember his rank.
Lieutenant, I think.
Lieutenant, yes.
Oh, here he is. Hello. Hello, nice man.
Chief.
Did you watch Forward Unto Dawn?
Unfortunately
oh,
for us,
I did. I like it more than Nightfall.
Really?
Yeah, because
I agree, actually. I like it more than
Nightfall. More interesting action, but the story, I like them both equally.
Yeah. So
that's my two comments
about. So this dude right here,
This dude is a good dude. He's another Dorker dude in the future.
He's the protagonist of... Oh, do we have to start the...
We have to get the jetpacks.
Oh, this right. All right. I'm going to jetpack.
That's a British brand, I know.
How do I use it? Oh, X? Man, when we switch between all these different games, I always forget what the controls are.
Yeah, thanks a lot, Team 43.
Hello, Captain Salty. I'm so angry that you're doing a good job of protecting the universe.
I don't want you to disrupt the secret war, or else it will go public.
Okay, so I can't see any of these things. I'm on the wrong side of the
sniper,
man. Oh, you're right. You're right. When you're right, you're right. And you're right.
And when you're right, you're always right. You're always right.
That's baseball reference.
Yes. Reference for today. Do you want to pick up that tower up there on the ridge?
Yes, sir. Right away, sir.
There you go.
There's the fireworks.
This guy's brave. He's just standing on the nose of the ship. Try me. Come at me, bro.
Yeah, exactly. Come at me, bro.
All right. I always laugh when I play these games. I always laugh like how many important jobs we give to the grunts. They're like, hey,
especially the grunts where they say,
the 3-foot-tall goblin monster, you're gonna be the one commanding this turret.
Might as well have a scuba mask and have a boat behind your back. Then you call yourself a grunt.
What are the grunts' real Halo names?
Ungoy, I believe.
Yeah,
I'm trying to pronounce it right.
You got a UNNGOY.
Yes.
It is nerd fest up in here. That's why he calls it dorky. Oh, I just got hit. There's something. Who shot me?
It's someone from the tower, I think.
Oh, there are elites on the ground. Are you on the turret? Oh, you're right here. I'm gonna get on the turret.
Ooh.
Come at me, bro!
Really disappointed. Came out, they made such a big stink about these behemoths that I really thought that this was gonna be a part of the multiplayer. I thought it was gonna be kind of like a battleship versus battleship kind of thing.
Yeah.
That would have been so cool.
And I agree.
Nothing ever came of it. They never got featured in it.
Oh, the sniper rifle's right here.
And you can't even drive it. Oh, there's a sniper rifle? This thing's got everything, man.
Yeah.
Where's the onboard?
Thank God for mammoths,
Where's
right?
Where's the onboard restroom?
I am right here, jumping around as I can be.
What do you think the bathrooms are like in this thing? Probably pretty spacious, huh?
If it's like Iron Man, then that's a different story.
You think they have like a full bar that you can like walk in?
Hey, I'm Master Chief. Drinks on me.
Yeah, right. I would let the chief buy me a drink, man.
Hell yeah.
He wouldn't talk.
I would go with him on trick-or-treating for cosplay reasons.
He wouldn't be a very good conversationalist, but at least nobody...
He's a man of few words, like Clint Eastwood.
Nobody would mess with you. Oh, dude, I'm going to take a warthog out here, because we have to clear the debris, don't we?
Yeah.
Or something?
We have to pick up the target designator.
That's right. You know, what's sad is drove into that acid river. Is it like a river of Mountain Dew or something? I don't know what that is.
Do the dew.
Do the dew. Don't do the dew in this case, because I would have died.
Because that is just...
I would have doo-doo died. Oh, see? Oh, almost did it again. Oh, is that the target designator?
That's right.
Heck yeah. Kaboom, boom, boom.
Boom, chaka-laka-laka.
Doing
there
it.
You go.
Yeah, baby.
That's how the UNC does it, ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah.
You saw it here first.
You take a GPS coordinator and you point a laser at the bad guy.
Beat that, Apple.
And then he goes boom. All right, so we got to take out this dropship coming in.
But if you must know, boom goes the dynamite.
Boom does go the dynamite. Passes it to the man. We got a couple ghosts out here. You think you can get me some cover on one of those turrets?
Oh, I'm ready.
Oh, you're on the ground.
We got boots on the ground. That's what.
Oh, dang, dude. A good call using the target designator on that giant eyeball thing.
No! Ooh, ooh! No, get out of there!
Oh, man.
I barely saw
that. My insurance rates just went up. Just skyrocketed. Why did you drive the Warthog under that giant 20-foot wheel? I don't know. I don't have a... And they're also leaving without us.
Can well, they're stopping now,
open the butt door.
Open the back butt door,
the
yeah.
Back butt
I was about to make a South Park reference, but that's not appropriate.
No, thank you.
You're welcome.
I respect you refraining. All right. Oh, there's rockets in here, too?
Yes, there is.
There's a bunch of weapons all over the walls.
It's like UNSC heaven in here.
I thought this game was a little too short, in my opinion. I feel like we all
I think Halo 5 heard that and thought, hey, let's put in more levels.
Well, let's put in more levels by having you play as different characters.
Yeah.
Which is like, hey, remember how everyone loved
they have
that
their
about
own
Halo 2?
I'd say they have their own reasons, but I'm not sure we would agree with those reasons, you know?
Absolutely not.
Mm-mm.
I think they're stupid reasons. Stupid.
Redonkulous
stupid
people reasons.
Stupid reasons. Let's shoot this phantom out of this guy, bro. You got that rocket launcher?
Oh, I
got a target designator. Don't we need that for the... Oh, it's unlimited as long as the thing's up in there.
Yeah.
This
it's not like
about
reach,
to kill
though.
Me. Yeah.
There's a fireworks I'm looking for.
I love it. Oh, dang, dude. Watch out for those...
Banshees?
The Banshees are...
Yeah, I thought you got hit by those.
The Banshees are screaming. Joe, throw me in. Come on. Come on, coach. I'm ready.
Game as hard as I can.
Ah, there we go.
Yeah, there we go. That's
it. I spawned and then I got hit by... Okay, here we go. I need some kind of power.
I was looking at you the entire time, but I was like, okay, now I gotta shoot something.
Force field, barricading the far side of this canyon.
Okay. Spoiler alert, I'm not very good with the sniper rifle. Keep drawing them out. I'm gonna see what I can do.
I'm okay with the Warthog, let's just say that. I'm not...
Oh, is that the Gauss Cannon Hog? That's my favorite one, man. I love that Gauss Cannon.
I think that comes in later or in the...
Oh, that's a machine gun. That's a machine gun. Never mind. Yeah. What are these bros back here?
Well, they should have Gauss Cannon by now. I mean, they had one in, like, Halo... Oh, yeah, they had one in Halo Reach. That's it.
I like how in this one you could do both... you could have both a gadget and you can still spin.
Oh, there's a horn.
Oh, you better watch yourself.
You better watch yourself.
So, we're playing this Halo 4 game, and...
He'll avenge my death.
And
yes.
Yeah, I got you. So, have you been playing any of the Call of Duty games recently?
No.
No, okay. So, one of my
biggest... But I get the idea
beefs,
of it, though.
One of my biggest beefs with the gaming industry now is it seems like everybody, as soon as Halo had such a big success...
That didn't take much damage.
They thought to themselves, hey, you know what sells Halo? Why don't we just make... Oh! Gotcha. Why don't we just make every game like Halo? So, if you go and see any of these, especially these new Call of Duty games that came out, even... in Christmas of 2015 and 2016, it's like Halo, but it's made by Call of Duty people.
Yeah.
And then when Halo's
speaking of Infinite Warfare,
Halo keeps making stuff, and you go, wait, is this Call of Duty? Like they keep like mixing their genres.
Yeah. Have you heard like arguments saying, Call of Duty stole from us or Halo stole from us? I'm not sure if you heard those arguments because I recently did.
They all just want to play the blame game, the player game stuff.
Yeah, that's true. It's like never-ending battles.
I mean, you know how I feel about Halo 5.
For most of the story, but I heard the multiplayer made up for it. It's like the reverse of Doom. The multiplayer's bad, but the campaign is good. But the campaign's bad in Halo. It's for most people,
for
some people.
Yeah, they just keep
But the multiplayer makes up for it, especially Firefight.
They keep alluding that, I remember when they were...
Run this thing over.
Oh, dang. This bro's right here. Snooper rifle. All right, check it, bro. Grenade. Check it, bro. Grenade.
That should take care of things.
Can't stop me, baby. Oh, there's a Wraith over here, dude.
I will hijack it.
The sooner the better.
I will. Trust me, I will.
Are you hijacking it or are you going to destroy it?
Oops.
Did you jump off? Hey, you blew it up.
Is that okay?
Your manager delivers on his promise? Yeah. I'd rather have it destroyed than us trying to use it.
It may be a little bit slow despite its boost packs, you know?
The boost.
Booster.
The boost packs.
As you can see, I'm holding a pistol like in the game.
Oh, dang, that is like the exact same one. Oh, they blew up
Inception.
The turret.
Inception. I was about to make good use of Gauss Hog.
Oh.
Only the controllers weren't acting up.
Got me. You got me. It like wasn't even difficult for me.
Bummerific. Heyo.
I know. Alright, wait for the respawn me.
I'm gonna get to a safe place.
Any minute now. says there's enemies nearby.
Oh.
Okay, here I am.
Not so much. Oh, well, you know what we could use? We could use rocket launchers.
Oh, I got one right here. How convenient.
How convenient indeed.
All right, let's see.
Ever heard of rocket sniping? I learned that from ODST. I'm not
rocket
sure if you
snipes?
Heard of
it.
Yeah.
Do these have the lock-ons? They don't, huh?
No, they don't. Oh!
Oh, dang!
But that was a bullseye right there, underneath.
That's a bingo. Nice.
Oh, there goes
one. You're a jump shooter, huh? Oh!
I'm more of a...
All right, we gotta take that Wraith out, dude.
Yeah, I'm trying to get it covered first. And I'm on the ghost.
I missed both shots, and then I died.
Oh, I'll get somewhere safe. If they stop shooting me first. There we go. This way.
Oh, I was like, where are we going? Oh, they're over here?
Yeah.
I wonder if I could find my,
I wonder if you can hijack one of these things.
I think
you Maybe you might do a better job than me. Of like, make sure it's
he's
not
distracted.
Destroyed.
Oh, he's really coming at you, dude. You got other ghosts coming up on you too, by the way.
Yeah, I do. You can pick up my rocket launcher if you want. Oh!
Dude.
A minute to spare, 2 minutes to spare at least.
Oh, hey! Now we're back in with the rocket launcher! That's what's kind of nice about
How nice of you, 343. You do have some benefits after all.
Oh, I forgot that we have the jetpack rockets. Come on, that's what the jetpack was built for.
Yeah, we're like the new Boba Fett of the UNSC. Except we're not working for the bad guys.
And we
barely miss, unlike Stormtroopers. Hey,
got him! Yeah, that's right. No way.
No way, no how.
I don't miss anything. All my bolts go exactly where I wanted to.
Oh, that was a long shot. That was sweet.
Nice.
If only we could get a replay of that. Boom. There we go.
I can do that in post.
I was thinking the exact same thing.
So many
if we have time
so
for
many
it,
things
though.
You can fix in post. Oh, wait. I got him. Nope, I missed. Yep.
I got him
is,
for
this
you.
This is how it ends. Heads up. Nice. Great. Well, I think that's going to have to conclude our Halo 4 segment right there. So stay tuned. We'll be right back with finally something that will make this hat that I'm wearing relevant.
I so hope so. Relevant.
All right, stay tuned.
Connect with history books, everybody, with this.
Bye. So
we got sights on, right?
The best thing that could happen out of World War III was we would get more video games based on World War III.
And it would be a modern, you know, take on World War III instead of just World War I, II. Hey!
What's up? Welcome back to Dorker Dudes. I am John, wearing this very fancy British beret. And this is Master Chief.
Well, I'm just a regular Spartan. I'm a wannabe Master Chief, so don't get confused, people.
What we're looking at right now is probably my favorite game that I'm playing at the moment. It is Battlefield 1, which is developed by EA DICE. They have been known in the past to put games out long before they were actually ready to be played.
Wouldn't Titanfall count?
Wasn't that the same guys that did the Infinity War, dude?
I think it's EA and Respawn.
Okay, well, either way, Battlefield 1 has been one of my favorite games that I've been playing recently, and I thought that since Dustin is always introducing me to stuff, I would get to give him a chance to try to go a few rounds. So, I got this last fall. I don't buy a lot of Xbox One games because I think they're pretty pricey, but this one I couldn't pass up.
That is true, everybody.
This one is the first Xbox game I've ever played that allows you to have 64 players in a match. And that's pretty impressive for a console. Not a lot of console games do that.
Impressive for a big militia group right there.
Exactly.
Very big one.
It allows you to play with up to
for its money.
You and four of your friends in a squad, which allows you guys to work together inside one of my favorite game types, which is capture and hold the flags in conquest. So this one is based around World War I. I thought they actually did a pretty good job of representing World War I pretty well. And the opening sequence, it's this whole huge battle, and at the end of it, there's only two guys left on the field, and they just drop their weapons and look at each other. And it basically this whole huge graphic.
It's a stare off.
Yeah, well, it kind of is though at the end. They're kind of like, what's the point? Everyone else is dead. And this little title comes up and it says, everyone thought that World War I was the war that would end all things, but it changed nothing. And it's like, oh, geez, that's really sobering. now I'm gonna play a game where I shoot people. So maybe, I don't know, maybe the
mixed feelings, isn't it?
Was lost. Have you played any of these Battlefield games before?
No, I haven't, but I've seen gameplay on YouTube. They look pretty cool, and I hear the sound effects are very top-notch.
So, EA DICE is about to release a DLC, their first one for this game. They've been known to put out games for $60, and then a couple months later release an extension of the game for an additional $50. So,
will they have, like, trench wars or something?
Yeah. In this one?
Yeah, like, in Battlefield 1.
You mean they're adding it to it? What do you mean, trench wars?
You know, like, you can fight in the trenches.
Yeah, that's World War One.
Yeah, that's what I'm asking, because I thought that in the original, before the DLC, there wasn't any.
They should make a game type where you sit and you dig a trench for 3 months, and then you get killed by mustard gas.
You mean like Minecraft style, where that time has to spy for like 5 minutes?
Yeah, you have to dig like a hole.
Yeah.
Like a latrine, and if you don't change your socks when it's wet, you'll get trench foot, and then they have to amputate your feet.
Yeah.
Would you play that game?
Well, as long as it's not Civil War, game where it's like you have to pump the gun, then boom, but you die during your reload, that'll be embarrassing.
Someone tried to put out a first-person shooter of World War One, and don't think we're gonna... Okay, all right, so here we go. I'm jumping in the game. I got my beret on, you bloody Yanks. All right, so here I am on the back of a... I'm riding my cavalry. All right, so I got...
Four-legged cavalry, everybody.
Check out this cool sword I got. I'm like a knight. But instead
charge
of
the Black House,
I also have a rifle. So this is one of my favorite unit types to play as, because what's cool in this game is since it takes place in World War One, they had to do things that were period appropriate. So
like Lawrence of Arabia.
Instead of motorcycles, they have
horses.
Horses, because you know horses are definitely the World War version of
motorcycles.
So I'm gonna go right around, and okay, someone's shooting at me. So someone just shot at me from up here. So right now in this version in Conquest, I like this because it requires a lot of teamwork. So I'm riding around and can kind of act as a scout.
I'm for teamwork games. I like them more than ones where you're against each other. I'm not that good.
Here we go.
Probably you don't mind me saying it, Aldi.
Oh, I missed. I got that guy. Yes.
Nice.
Time to run away.
Did you just kill three people in 3 seconds?
No, I'm not that good. Okay, I am that good, but that's not what happened.
You're that good to me.
So, thanks, man.
You're welcome.
Yeah, I really appreciate it. My own horse. Okay, I was kidding. I thought my horse ran me over. Okay, now it's your turn, Master Chief.
You got it, sir.
It's pretty standard first-person shooter controls. So, can you see through that helmet?
Oh, yes, I can. It's brighter now. I mean, it's not pitch black.
Okay, well, we'll see what happens. I'm gonna take a sip of my drink. A spot of tea, governor. Someone rezzed you. So technically, I didn't die, but I'm gonna let you play anyways. This is a semi-automatic rifle you got. It's got 5 rounds, it's pretty great. You have some.
So which button's zoom?
L-trigger.
L-trigger?
Zoom with L-trigger.
There we go, that's why I remember from Call of Duty.
You switch weapons with Y, you crouch with B.
And I think the left joystick is sprint, I remember that.
And then you melee with down on the right stick. So there's a guy up there on that building, you see him?
Oh, nice, I got that jumping thing. Oh,
that's Snake's coming right for you. He's gonna run you over!
Someone shoot me right now.
You and I have a knack for getting ran over in these games. Master Chief, you probably want to keep your helmet on if you're gonna be getting shot. Okay, well,
they're spraying bullets, so that's fine. I'm a wannabe Master Chief. Remember that, audience. I'm not the Master Chief.
Has a gun, and she missed. All right, so right now, it's funny how we're losing, yet we have, like, all the dang stuff. All right, so I'm going to spawn here at B. All right, so here we go. The building's on fire.
Oh, you got a knife at the end. That's
good.
Yeah,
I got a bayonet. So what's cool about this game is, in the last... That wasn't cool.
That is not cool at all.
Just do it. You have to pull the slide back, and then.
And I.
Next time.
Okay, now I'm alive.
How do they keep rezzing you? Okay, fine. Okay, so in this one they added weather effects, way more than so. In Battlefield 4 they introduced that in any map that you're playing, you know, fog will roll in. There'll be a dust storm. Now
it's. Yep.
I think eventually we're probably gonna get hit with a dart. But it's not gonna be today. All right, here we go.
You know what we say to death? Not today.
All right, so we have, look at our team's coming
Game of Thrones reference.
Oh, we're actually winning right now.
Yeah, are we on red or blue?
Oh, we're the blue team. Okay,
so here we go. That's their guy. Weapon.
That's, yeah, okay, so we're.
He stole your horse. Revenge on him. Revenge on him.
I'm gonna try to find a guy that I'm gonna run through with my bayonet. Children at home, it's time to cover your eyes because you're going to see the horrors of war. Isn't it kind of weird?
Cosplay, you'll never see
real people fought and died in these wars, and they're like, let's make a video game.
Yeah, we get to kill people.
Let's have a game that people play.
Oh, an audience, you'll never see a shovel the same way ever again once
no,
you.
No, that's true.
See?
Oh! Yeah, baby, it's through. I got you, mate.
I got you.
Check this out. So I'm going to take with the syringe and give him a vaccine, and now he's alive. No more polio for you. Okay.
What else learning we get? Polo, Alfred.
All right, what do we got?
Oh, there's a machine gun right there.
Oh, there's a machine gun. I can never use these in the game. All right.
Now's my
little friend. All right, hopefully somebody can spot some dudes. Oh, yeah, here we go. Got you. Yeah. Oh, dang. Okay, here he comes. Oh, also, I have a golden pistol.
Sick grenade, woo!
Called the Swede.
The golden Swede, that looks so good.
All right, let's go find a dude to bayonet. What do you say?
If John Wick was really a Time Lord, he would have been proud of that weapon.
Yes, I think so. I still have to see that movie. Where are these dudes?
Second one.
Oh!
Run for your life and kill at will.
Right in the neck.
There you go.
They got to check you for thyroid problems. Here you go. Up you go, baby.
I saved your life.
Oh, dang. Oh, gosh.
No, you got a kill assist. That's good.
There's a tank, bro. I'm going to go hide.
Oh, I thought you actually killed somebody.
The best defense from bullets in this game are sand dunes. Just hide behind them. All right, so.
That's not sand
people
roll.
I'm the medic right now. That's true. He went prone. Oh,
no.
Right in the pectoral. All right.
Knights of Columbus, that hurts.
Yeah, right. Great. Odin's beard.
Great Odin's Raven.
All right, let's see what else you got.
All right, let's see. I think A.
So A is the enemy. So you can see the red one's being held by the enemy. So you're gonna spawn on that one.
Yes, I am.
Ooh, sentry kit. Do you think you get to it? It's probably at C.
Location. C, okay.
Go get the sentry. Oh, your buddy's gonna grab it. Yeah, run and grab it right there. You have to get around the other side and you have to press X to grab it. This is gonna make you a super soldier. All right, turn right. No. That thing, that white thing. Yeah.
I see it.
Grab it. So now you have like a heavy machine gun. Choo. All right, so Dustin is now going to be the World War I version of the Terminator.
Dun.
Watch where your red reticle's coming.
Yeah, I'm trying to find who's shooting me.
Oh, there we go. You have to aim. You have to kind of use short control bursts. I don't think you're shooting anybody. Yeah, go get him. Go run at him. So careful, they can assassinate you if they sneak up behind you. They will little knife. They'll poke you. Oh. What's happening? What's gonna happen?
So many rockets in here.
I know, you think
be a pity if someone exploded them.
There's a guy. Come on, you gotta kill one of them. No, Dustin, no! Oh, well, somebody killed him for you. You have 16 health, so what's unfortunate about the sentry kit, guys, is that if you go get cover, that sniper's gonna get you. Can you aim with L trigger? Yes. I don't know.
I'm trying to find the guy. I don't know who
was shooting at you. You guys are up 200 tickets. Horse! Ah! Keep shooting him.
Horse wounded.
Did you get him? Oh, you got the assist again. See what about these sentry kits is you get a lot of assists. I don't know if you get
I'm
on
surprised
that horse.
You can sprint this thing.
You get on that horse.
That'd be nice. You're like I have a machine gun. No way.
You're this big sentry kit guy on a horse. Oh, awesome. You also have your sword again. So you actually have health on the back of that horse you can throw.
I'll let you ride this horse.
Are you sure?
Yes, it's your horse, supposed to be.
Not yet. Don't do it. Okay, so the horse is healing up, but I am not. So I'm gonna jump off and cheat.
An enemy
armored train. Oh, here comes the enemy armored train. All right.
We're gonna go Lawrence of Arabia on those enemies.
Well, what's cool in this one,
this one wasn't so
campaign-centric as the last couple ones, but what's funny is that you bring that up is in, did you know that? In this one, as a campaign, you fight alongside Lawrence of Arabia?
I've seen some videos of it, yeah, it's just been a while.
So what's cool is they introduced in this battlefield that whatever losing team, if a losing team gets down 100 points, this is a field gun.
I was about to get to that, but someone was shooting at me.
This is what we used to destroy the moon. All right. So the enemy armor train is going to be coming from that way.
You mean destroy the Death Star?
Ayo. I can't see it. So these enemy armor trains, they basically every map has its own version. It's either a blimp,
or a zeppelin,
a big boat. Yeah, zeppelin, a big boat,
what's zeppelin
or
the
train. Okay, here we go.
Oh, I think I see it.
It's an enemy down here.
Ow, 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 ow. Bro, that's not cool, bro. You get a grenade, and you get a grenade. Oh, okay.
Oh, whoa.
Oh.
Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. Worst thing to say. That's why I wear the glasses.
No, I'm curious. Where did it hit you?
Right in the temple. It was a
that was
a great shot.
It could have been like the hat, but like.
I think I have brain damage now, honestly. If I pass out, don't let me fall asleep. I might have a concussion.
Yeah, that could have been as worse as like saying
it. Been doing, oh, you can res that guy with right on the, oh, that guy in front of you is gonna kill you. Right on the D-pad.
Right on the D-pad.
And get him. Get him. Do it. Do it. Get the R trigger.
I'm new at this.
Sorry. So yeah, you have gadgets. She's good with that, so I'm getting out of the way. Okay, let's see. I'm pretty sure we're gonna win this, because right now it's 500 to 250. Oh, dude. You know what time it is? Oh, no, I don't want that one. I don't want that one. Okay, hold on.
Let me guess.
It's core. Rocket gun time.
Yeah, about to say core is light train, but okay.
Yeah, right.
This was before that, I think.
Yes, it was much before that. Okay, so I have this rocket gun. So what's cool in this one is you can't, what's kind of dumb about the first couple of games is everybody and their mothers had rocket launchers and you could run around with them. I missed. Oh, I missed.
So the mother thing, that's why I was nodding my head.
Behemoth, look at how much damage I'm doing this thing. Oh man, I missed.
This might be the equivalent of missile sniping.
So this one, you can only use it when you're prone.
Behemoth hit, that's good.
Yeah, which is kind of cool. You can only use this rocket gun when you're prone, which means you have to lie down flat. In the last couple games, you just have people running around, you know, rocket jumping.
Pa!
So check this out, watch this. Here's the train. I'm gonna go, you get one, you get two.
See, everyone gets one.
Everyone gets dynamite. Oh, there's gold in them near hills. Yeah! Boom!
Oh, yeah. Let's
42 damage. All right, so I have nothing left to hit this guy with, so I'm just gonna, yeah! Oh, dang it! I forgot it wasn't fully auto.
Right at the heart, that's a good shot. I have to respect that.
So go ahead and spawn in. Do you want to spawn in as the assault guy or the medic? Do you want to try the big heavy machine gun?
Yes.
All right. Oh, I got you. There you go.
All right. Here Do comes it. The cavalry, baby.
Do it.
Letter D, just like my name.
D for Dustin.
D for Dorker Dudes.
Dorker Dudes, DD. Your designated DD, designated driver. Your designated driver. That doesn't make any sense. All right.
Yeah, because it's repeated.
I want you to run head on at that train. Thomas the Tank Engine.
The evil version of it.
Dun, 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 dun. Bum, 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 bum.
You can't really jump. Oh, yeah. Bum,
bum. You do have a repair tool, a wrench that you could go hit the train with, and it would actually do damage.
Here we go.
Oh, that guy right there on your left.
You mean the guy on the horse?
No, not him. That's a friendly. That guy. Oh, sorry. I thought I saw a dude. There was a dude. He ran off or something. So your bullets will not do. Oh, that guy. There he is.
There he is. He was right there. Someone avenged
Dustin
me.
Dustin died. No, now she's going to shoot me by accident.
Just pull the trigger.
Just do it.
Just do it. Thank you, Shia LaBeouf.
All right. Here we go again. Go and do it again. All right. I'm going to hit this bad boy. All right. Bad boy.
Bad boys, bad boys. What you gonna do when they come for you? On the train, on the train.
Oh, turret disabled.
Yes, finally.
Behemoth hit. I'm lobbing him.
There you go.
Behemoth
you
hit.
You arced it right there. That's good.
I know what I'm doing. I know what I'm doing. Get out of my way, horsey.
I believe you.
Yeah! All right, let's see in these last couple minutes if I can run up and throw some more dynamite. So, do you enjoy this game? It's fun, right? Maybe.
I think it was fun to watch.
Is it not your cup of tea?
Well, I haven't played yet, and I'm not really that, you know, open mind with like new controllers to play games, except for Doom and Halo and maybe Titanfall. I have to warm up to that too.
Maybe outside.
But I've seen Let's Plays of this. It looks really cool.
Maybe when I got that guy, by the way. I'm so good. I'm good at games. You know that, I barely tell you that. Oh!
Yeah.
Mr. Horsey, come back!
Do not insult the Borat Master!
We need to make some Elmer's glue. Let's go get that horse. So it said you can get skins for your guns too. I really enjoy this game.
I enjoy that gun, really.
I would suggest looking into it if you're wondering, because at this point, especially with the DLC coming out,
Battlefield 1 available now.
There are we can't get something. We can't get sued. All right.
Good point.
So we still have a couple minutes here. Let's see.
But they should know by now.
Oh, this guy. We're going. Ball.
Trenches. There's a trench.
Got him. There's another one. Got him. Oh, jeez.
You flew.
I did. I also got a couple kills with the pistol. Just do it. Oh. He's hit me in the face. You miss him. All right. Next one.
Well, you play anyway.
She should play this game, man. She's better shots than you and me combined. All right. So let's see here. What do we got? So it seems like all your points are kind of slightly contested. I don't know. Yeah, spawn at B and let's see what kind of damage you can do. I want you. Oh, you're going in with the support gun, huh?
Yeah, why not,
right?
All right,
let's see what you could do, man.
More damage the better. For nearly 2 minutes.
For nearly 2 minutes. 2 minutes of carnage.
Unlike Carnage, that villain from Spider-Man.
Oh, jeez.
I like that. I like Venom and Carnage because they have that creature look to it, you know?
I'm wondering if they're going to bring that back in this next Homecoming movie. If that's... Oh, get that dude. Get him.
Do it. Oh!
You got him, man! Oh, then
we died together, just like now.
I'm surprised you just... Dude, she's been hitting me in the face multiple times.
She shot me in the heart, she shot me in the chest, she's good.
Shot through the heart. And
thank you, mysterious person, whoever you are.
She's to blame. Oh, dude, okay, we're gonna take A real quick. Probably play this for another...
I'm glad that you have those respawn systems, where you can spawn
on your buddies. It's pretty cool,
and
right?
You have a bird's eye view of where to do it.
Yeah, I really enjoy this game.
Yeah, I think
I don't know how many times I'm gonna say that in the rest of our
time. And how many times we're gonna say convenient.
How convenient? Oh, dang it. No more bullets.
Well, there's one underneath the wheel somewhere.
All right, so I think that kind of draws today's episode of Dorker Dudes to a close, wouldn't you think?
I think it closed on a successful note. Would you say, with the army?
Sure. So we got to do a little throwback, both to 2001 to 2012, and we got to play something more recent.
We went and then slinged it all the way to the past.
What do we have to? Oh, we got revived. What do we have to look forward to next week? You think?
Next week, I believe we're gonna have a massive march to the month of March with the Andromeda Galaxy group. I mean, do you know anything about this?
About the Andromeda? Well, I know that Mass Effect's gonna be coming out pretty soon. We gotta get caught up on everything, right?
Mm-hmm.
Well,
no matter how many people.
It's been a pleasure playing with you.
Pleasure playing with you, sir.
We'll see you on the other side. Tune in next time
this
for Dorker
side,
Dudes.
Other.
Yeah, right? We'll always have more games to play and more dorky things to talk about.
Exactly. More ways than one. Stay classy, Spartans.
Thanks so much.
Game over.